Hello there and welcome to another lesson from Delta Blues Tips. This is called, it's going to be loosely based and called the Acoustic Guitar Player's Toolbox. And in your toolbox you find all your little handy bits, don't you? Well, these are little handy moves that you can use to make your acoustic guitar player a little bit more special. Standard tuning. Let's take a look. I'm going to hit a G chord. What this is all about is little harmonies you get in between when you're changing. There's one. G. Ends neatly enough on a G. That would be shaped like an A chord. So those three there are a G. And before we get into this, I just want to show you the kind of thing we can be doing with these. I was just going to an A minor chord. Get the idea? Now we can use these all over the place, like I've just said. Let's have a look at the first one. So first, the B and the G string open. First and second fret. Third and fourth. Fifth. Seventh. Eighth and ninth. Tenth and 11th. 12th. Idea. And of course, it's the way we hit it. Let's just take a look at how we do it. You can do, as you're learning them, you can do them straight. Just thumb and first finger like this. And what you do is now you break them up into small chunks. So I might go. Do the first three like this. Great introduction for the next chord. Say we were going to go to the A minor. That's all about the way we hit it. This one. It's a G chord. That little finger is playing an F chord. This is a G chord now. We're interested in those two. So that's going from 3rd and 4th, 5th, 7th. And one that comes to mind immediately is Clapton's version of Knocking on Heaven's Door. He plays this very run backwards and then plays the A minor like this. That kind of thing. Like an A minor 7. Now, it's how we treat it. See the feel I put on that? So in effect what I'm doing here is sliding, playing that note, then that one. That one. That one. Then that one. Where you use both of them there. Let's have a look at that. G. G. Either those two, or mostly these two. Thin as you like by just using the bottom string. See that? See that one? I'm going backwards here from the 7th. Flick through. Back to the 5th. A minor. This one. To all of that. Take a look at that last move there. Excuse me. Open. Split them. B string first, G string second. C chord. Now with this, we could use the bits we used in the Neil Young one. Just using my thumb. What shall we drop into this one? Now, this one, what I'm just about to do now, we're now going to use this one and that one. B string and D string open. First and second. Third and fourth. Fifth. Seventh. Eighth and ninth. Now, K keep a look at that there, because I want to show you something, where this lies, why it lies this way. This is a D chord. I move that up to the 7th fret. I'd see it as a full chord. Look at that one, and that one. That's how it ends in G, because it's part of that chord, see? So we might go. There's the G. When you're hitting these, of course, all depends on what way you want to start using these fingers. Thumb and first finger. Let's put the three together. Now that one, you can do two off to, like this. Could leave this one on. Now this comes in great for hammering, and this is what nearly unders all the while. Idea. Let's take a look at that. G. I'm going to do that in a slow, soulful way. Here's that little run. See there, hammer and pull off. Let's look at that little move there. Split the strings. It's a good way to practice that. I'm just using the B string and the G string. Hitting the string underneath. So it's the G, this note, and you just balance it. Let's take a little look at that move there. How we were doing that. can get the other hand in. See all the harmonies you can make now. I'm starting to make all the harmonies. Listen to this. Sorry, not getting that in there. Was a lot. This one. Oh, you can go to a C chord, it'd be great for that, listen. Now, when we get up to the G, which is here, in the 7th fret, it starts, you start producing the same moves, see? So this is G. Sorry, this is G. I do the same thing underneath using the E and the G string. We're now, we'll end up in the key of C. Because an F chord, once it starts getting moved, G, 5th and 7th is A, and if we play up on the 8th fret, it's a C. So now we've got, so that's C, that's G. Fret and 4th fret, 5th fret, 7th. So see how these things work? So when you're playing some harmony with other players, you can start moving around quite a bit now. Let's get this out so I'll show you. Do a thing like this. Now it's a good little exercise you can try out to get the flow going. Let's take this one in G. So that's G. If we use the same thing on these two strings, see that? What we've got now is D, G, and we can do a little run all the way down to G like this. Actually doing there. Now we move on to the G string and the A string. Check that out with the other hand, what we're doing there. Not making mistakes when I'm looking at the camera, but my lessons are live, so you know. Went up the other way there, get the idea though. So let's try G to E minor. G to C. G to A minor. G to D. Now, are we starting to see the picture? That's the main thing. Let's have a look at another way. By the way, these are all movable all over the guitar, these. Let's take a look at a D chord. That's a full D chord. Bad. See that? Now all these are the parts we've been using for the harmonies. Let's take a look at what's on the bottom down here. Here's your D. Without playing the full one. These two. G. Remember, this is just the bottom of it. We're going to go D to G. Second and third. Third and fifth. Fifth and seventh. Seventh and eighth. And we can end in A. By going to the 9th and 10th. See, so we've come out of D doing the same. D to A. Idea. And that's those two. Play the D chord again. Let's take a look at looking. Let's try these two. It's the bottom one. If I start running my finger over the top. See that kind of Mexican cantina type thing. That's taking it up to an A in the 9th and 10th fret. G. That's a D. C. Now why these ones are like this? Let's just take a look here. There's that one. Because that's... moving all the chords around now. There's the D as we're doing it. That's a D. At the fifth and seventh. Now when you start stringing these things together, you get some nice little techniques like this. I have to get this out a bit. Let's just try one. See where you're taking the step? Remember, it's just thumb and first finger all the while as you're doing these things. You've got all those little rolls going on now, like. Doing there, by the way, is I'm just creating harmonies within what I'm playing. So I'm just wanting to feel if I'm going to a C chord, so I just play it. But we're keeping a D going like this. So we can have so you're getting this feel. Play that little run for you like this, show you how to get a little technique on that. I am on that now. Sound much there, but as we move it, so now we've got like a straight D chord. Kind of thing we're doing here now, doing this kind of thing, is the D. And I'm playing the D when I run up here. Getting all that little thing going on there. I know I'm going off a little bit there, but All these things are well worth exploring when you're looking at these things. So let's see what we have now. D. Take it from these two. D. And you're working out exploring all these little things. There's a little roll going on. See that? Feel it up now. We're using all these and moving them around. There's the A. So we're getting the feel of it now, like, say. G. These two, C. Now, bearing in mind that these work anyway, we've been doing it in G. Let's move two frets up. At the fifth fret, we play an F. We now can do it in A. And what we did before in G. Just move to two frets now. Let's just go in and have a look. Well, we're going to play this now. We're in A now, so we're going from the fifth, seventh. So we'll go back from the ninth, seventh, fifth and sixth. Jump on these strings. Now, just using loads of electric rock shuffles and blues. So we're in A, adding these two, which we normally would play like that. Back again. I'm complicating that there, but there's lots of kind of bluesy things you can actually do with that. Now, if I use these fingers, we're using now for these now. One more time with this sound. I'll buy pick it. See what I mean? So that can get really complex when you're shuffling along, going really fast. And of course, if we're playing the blues, whatever we're doing here, or here, we can play. So let's pick the one we started with in G. That's what we started with. Now we're going to use this one as well. In effect, we're going to go. Let's have a look how we can mess with that one. See what I mean? Now let's try one in A. say you play another guitar player, going A to B minor this time. There's the A. Got a B minor. Do that in from the fifth, seventh, ninth. See the slide? See how I'm putting them together now? You could shift the B minor. Let's have a look. That's an F minor chord. And of course, it's movable. If we play it up at the 7th and 9th, it becomes a B minor. And there's one here now, watch. So it's going 7th, 9th, 10th and 11th. So in effect we could do this. Let's go from A. B minor. So is the B minor one. To A. So we're to follow the way, right the way through. There's the A. B minor. See the different ways? Just take a look at what we're doing here. Let's take a little look. Whoops. So we're going from the 10th and 11th. 9th, 7th. So in effect, when you want to get that B minor sound, you could actually just go. Now you could use the A to introduce the B minor like this. playing that A backwards from the 9th to the 7th, 5th and 6th into the B minor. Just take a look what my hand's doing there. We dropped into it that time. So we're going to drop in. So I just do little touches. There you go. That is a great way of making sure you start to understand. We use G, A, B minor, a bit of D. That's how to get those things moving. When you add all those to the way you're playing, it gives you that little bit of extra thing you need. Remember, concentrate. So where I'm shaking my hand there, creating vibrato. Concentrate on loads of feel. And you look for other places, but bear in mind that the basic thing to do, before I finish this, I'll just show you this bit here. Like that all the while. See? Two. And you're just changing that shape all the while. If you work out and mess around with that, you'll get a good way of looking at it. So if you've donated and got this, really appreciate what you've done. And stick with it, because it's a great way of getting around on the guitar. That's part one anyway. I think there will be a part two. Catch you later. Thanks now.